Okay, so now I have started making the recording of the session, so that will keep going. So I was telling about you learning management system. It's a software platform on which we mount our course and we do the transaction, online transaction. We carry out assessment and we share our media, we share our content. Yes, I will share this recording later on once the session is over. So and then there are various kind of learning management systems. Broadly we can classify them into two groups. One is the proprietary systems, another is the open source systems. The proprietary systems are those like Blackboard, which you have to subscribe to, you have to purchase them, you have to pay money to use them, and they are very powerful. Like Blackboard is there, one of the example, Desire to Learn is there, so they are a good case where the advantage of these proprietary softwares are that there is a whole tech department available to you, which in case if you need some help, they will be there to support you. On the another side, there is open source version, like Moodle is open source. The open source, you don't pay for the software. This is freely downloadable. You can install it as per your convenience. And the limitation is that the company won't provide you the support. The company has given you the software and they expect that you train yourself and then use the software. So from their side, using the software, it's completely open. No issue to that. But then in case sometimes if something goes wrong, then what to do? There is no worry, because there is a large, you can see that it is written there, Moodle is the world's last most popular learning management system. And outside United States of America, Moodle all over the world is the most popular learning management system. So you can see that that way. And this is just to how to, there are other examples also, like Google Classroom is also there. Maybe some of you are using Google Classroom. They call it as a learning management system. And similarly, we have Drupal, we have Sakai, we have Joomla. They are a sort of a content management system in which we put our content into the system, and then we manage with the help of that our transactions, how we are going to use it. So that is managed from there. Moodle, you may be knowing about it. It is an acronym. It stands for Modular Object Oriented Dynamic Learning Environment. So the first thing is, it allows us to create our course structure in a modular way. So we create short modules and then arrange them so that a course is prepared. So the basic unit here is a course. In a course, we have like as in a traditional course, you can have various sections, various units, which we call, the unit is equivalent to a chapter. And then every chapter may have text, may have audio, may have video, may have exercises, your assignments, and any various kind of activities are available into it. So that makes it a very robust kind of system. And regarding security, it is highly secure system. Even if you are not enrolled in a course of your own colleague, you won't be able to see what is inside there. So that unauthorized access is very difficult in this system. The next two words are object oriented, OO. Object oriented has been taken from the programming from computer science field. Object oriented programming language, like you have procedural language. You must have heard about Pascal, Basic, COBOL, Fortran, and Java, R, Python, Ruby. There are so many programming languages nowadays we have. Similarly, Moodle is based on, it has been created using PHP. And the concept here is that every item is considered as an object. So everything around us is an object. So this mobile phone is an object, my specs object, the headphones are object, this laptop is an object. And every object, as in living world, particularly, they have certain properties. And one of the properties is heredity. So the properties are passed on from the parent to the offsprings. And that's why you see, in us, the human beings, or in the animal kingdom, you may be seeing that in a family, the family members may have similar facial features. So because due to the genetic conditions, the behavior, the physical appearance, it may resemble. So that's the heredity. And the benefit has been taken in the object-oriented field in that way, that you create one object, and then that object has certain properties. We can make use of those properties in the similar conditions because it will behave in a similar way. And the second property is that it can be ported to other conditions. So the benefit becomes here. For example, just see the print button. It remains the same wherever. Just when someone clicks on a print button anywhere, it tells the system that it has to print something. Where it will print, either on paper or on screen, that is defined there. As per the user input, it goes into it. So when we create a software, we don't write everything from the start. Whatever is already existing, we just take them in the bunches and assemble them, put them, and then integrate them. So that way it is object oriented. And then DLE, dynamic learning environment. It makes the learning a dynamic system, a dynamic environment, not a passive environment there. And how it is done? It is done by incorporating various kind of interactive activities through which we make the teaching learning process interesting, interactive, engaging, and then the students, they feel that they are involved into the system. And as you know that in teaching learning, we all are teachers and we all have our philosophy of teaching. Moodle also has a philosophy. It is based on the philosophy of constructivism. You must have heard now. Those of you who belong to, say, education field, you may be knowing that we have various theories of learning. So the philosophies of learning, like behaviorism. And if you have heard the name of the famous Russian psychologist, Ivan Pavlov, he made that famous example of the having the dog showing him the food, and when the dog sees the food, the dog salivates, and he repeats that experiment continuously for some time. So and when what happens, there is a behavior in the change, there is a change in the behavior of dog, that when he starts seeing that the person is coming, he thinks that the food is coming, and as soon as the dog thinks about the food, it salivates. And what happened then, after that, suddenly he goes in front of the dog but doesn't feed the food, but the dog still salivates because it is a change in behavior. And that's why the reward and punishment theory: for the good work done, you give the reward; for the bad work done, you give the punishment, and that way try to control the behavior. Similarly, there is another philosophy. It is called a constructivism, in which using our, like, we human beings, we interact with our external environment through five senses: sense of smell, touch, hear, see, like that. Through these senses, we explore the world and then develop our experience, and we learn something. On the basis of that, then we construct. To learn something, we construct. And that's why, if you know that the Bloom's taxonomy also shows you the, on the top, the creativity comes. That when, if you are able to make something, create something, it means that you have learned something. It's not necessarily that if you hear something, you will remember, or you will see something that you will remember. But if you do it, if you are able to perform something, it means you have learned it. And then it is based on constructionism. From construction, constructionism. that makes the base of we create something for others to learn. And that makes it an example that here now we are creating some experiences for others to learn. So this is a brief background of Moodle. Moodle was created in the year August 2002, and currently Moodle 3.8 is the latest version. May I request, please mute your microphone. Because there is some noise coming up.
Hello, madam.
Can you please? In fact, actually, it happens with those of you who are using your mobile phone. And if a call comes, your microphone gets unmuted. So I can unmute you, but I have to change my screen and then go to the main menu. And from there, I may have. So it's requested that. If you receive a call, then at least maybe you can lower the volume. Okay, thank you very much. And so this is related to Moodle. It's easy and it's installation because you will be installing it. It is always better to install. Now, first, where it can be installed. Now, this is the flexibility of Moodle that it can be installed. Okay, Naveen, it's good thing that you are able to create your website. Congratulations to you. Moodle can be installed on variety of platforms. See, you can install it on your pen drive, the USB stick. You can install it on that. You can install it on your laptop, your desktop as a standalone. Now, why do we use it on your desktop? Because there are course creators, course developers, the instructional designers who are professional in this area, who create courses for the companies, for the institutions there. They need to create their courses. And in that case, instead of going online always, you can install this Moodle on your local machine and do all the experimentation. The only difference is that you won't be able to share your course if it is installed on your own machine. Because to share it with others, you need to connect it. And then that makes it do the web version. You can install it on your university servers also. Once you install it on your university server, then you can add more teachers so that they can create their courses. And you can add students to go through your courses that way. And then in the institutional servers, there is a difference that you want to use the institutional server space or you want to use the cloud-based option, because there are various companies, including the Moodle company, they offer the cloud-based services. So you create everything in the cloud and it remains safe there, and you don't need to bother about its maintenance or something from there. This is related to its installation. That this site, which is currently you see on your screen, this is the Moodle company. From here, you can find the documentation of all kinds. Means its installation to learn about Moodle. Everything is detailed there. From the downloads, you can download the patch. And currently, as you can see, that 3.8 is the latest version. The Moodle has its accessibility on various platforms. So you have the desktop version, you have the mobile version, and you have the USB version. In fact, the Moodle company has also created one more version of it for those areas in which there is no internet connection. And perhaps if those of you who are either from STEM site, science engineering, you may be knowing that there is a piece of hardware. It is called as Raspberry Pi, which is open source hardware. Using that, the Moodle company, they have also created a small operators kind of thing, which if you install your courses and take it to certain place, like we have so many places there, then it will allow within a certain radius range. every machine which can connect through that through the signal, then they can access the course from there. Dr. Sadhana is asking, university server module creation can only be commercial. It depends on the purpose of the means the institution. They can use it for commercial or non-commercial purpose. It depends on them. The free account is just they ask you that I think they very recently they have changed there, but you need it continues for a long time. I think for past 1 year Dr. Sadhana is using it. I am using it for past many years, the free version, although I have my institutional ID with me because I am assisting many universities. But you need to log in at least minimum once in 14 days. If you create your account and if you forget to log in for 2 weeks into your account, it will send you a warning email that kindly log in. Otherwise, they will think that your account is inactive and they may reset the account. So that way, yeah, these 45 days they have here and created. That's why I'm suggesting you that you can, in Moodle Cloud, there is a limitation of 200 MB space and 50 students. You can't go more than that. That's why there is an alternative to create your ID on this Genomio also. Both are Moodle, both will work the same, no difference. The difference is only of the company. This Genomio is a private company. They won't charge you anything. The only thing that they will, you know, display some advertisements. So from there, that is their sustainability model for that. And the Moodle Cloud is for their company. So this is the website, and there is then is that a upgraded one? Yeah, the Moodle Cloud is already always the upgraded one version. Yes, so there is another website of Moodle company. It is called as moodle.net. This is that site. Yes, Dr. Sushma Bhardwaj is asking, can we shift our content from Moodle Cloud to Genomio? Yes, very well. We will show it to you how to do that. This moodle.net net site is for you to learn from the community. It is the forum on which those people who want to learn something and they need to ask something, they can go there and then they can, you know, pose their question, participate in the discussion forums, and then you need to, you know, they will guide you. You can ask your question that, okay, I'm having some difficulty with me in this area, in this activity, something like that, can anyone help me? So that's why the educators around the world, they can you know, help you out. So yeah, I think this around 1.5 months this trial period, they only, I think they have started doing it in the just last week, because of certain challenges being faced by them. But you can use it till then, and then you can take a backup of your course. We will show you how to do that, and in the meantime you can create your course on Genomio. But my recommendation to you, please talk to your institution and ask them to install it on the servers. Yeah, it is safe, no problem in that. Zoom is a different thing actually. In Zoom, anyone could go inside your course, and actually what happened, this is the stupidity of the people. If anyone posts their link publicly, share their password publicly, and then the people, they can come inside your course, they can install there, and then if they keep on clicking on anything, definitely there is a safety hazard. But otherwise, as of now, let me tell you, in the morning also I have used Zoom. It is safe. The only thing is that we do not know how to use it safely. Means that's why nowadays this Zoom company, they have made that waiting room feature. If anyone of you is using Zoom, you may be knowing that there is a feature of waiting room. they have activated as a by default it. So what is waiting room? It is something like there are some friends from Sonipat here. So you have entered the gate of say Hindu college there, but you have not entered any room. You have just entered the premises of the institution. So that is called as a waiting room, waiting area. Only after that, when the teacher who is holding the class, they will allow you one by one to enter the session, enter the class. So then it is like that. You are waiting in the waiting hall, and then someone will come and say, yeah, okay, your turn now, please come. And that. So that is the safety feature of it. In that case, you know to whom you will allow you to enter your class. That way. Otherwise, previously, anybody could directly go into the class. And then don't, I have seen so many, the password 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 or 9, 8, 7, 6 through 3. I don't use this kind of passwords. Let the system generate the password. Anyhow, the people, they just copy paste the password and nobody remembers it. So there are these few things. Anyway, you all are aware of these things, and I know that you handle these things quite effectively. So these are the two websites which are the official websites which you can use. Okay, Swatiji is asking, does the institution need to purchase license? If you are using Moodle, no license is required. It is open source. It is free of cost. You just need to, let me show you from where to download it. It's a very small file. I think around 60 MB nowadays currently. Moodle.you, for that you need to go to moodle.org. Moodle.net is for training purpose. And you click on downloads. You can see here the green button, and it is the download. Then you need to check that what you want to, you know, download. And it is always a good idea for you also to install this Moodle mobile app. There is only one Moodle mobile app in the world. That is the official mobile app. The advantage of Moodle mobile app is that to connect to Moodle, you need to be connected to internet. So when you are online, then you can access all the resources. So from teacher point of view, you need to create your course and access it. But if as a student you use it, then the certain content which is not streaming, like videos, barring that, the other things like images, your text, the Moodle mobile app, when you are offline, when you are not connected to internet or your data package has finished, you will still be able to access that. So that is the beauty of this mobile app, that even if even when you are offline, it allows you to access the course material. So it is a good idea that when you create your course, ask your students to download the mobile app. And it's a very light app. It's not heavy and doesn't steal your passwords or something. These Moodle people, they are honest people. That's why they have given this software free of cost to the world. So here is this latest release under standard Moodle, those of you who want to install it. Just keep seeing that there is one stable version and there is this normal version. It means that, see here, this package is built every week with new fixes by our stable development process. Yes. In time zone, please find for India, Kolkata, because we manage from, although it is for, if you know that our time is being measured from Allahabad, but in terms of time zone, we say it Kolkata. So in the drop down menu, either you will find Asia, Kolkata or India, or plus 5.30, because we are GMT plus 5 hours 30 minutes. That is the Indian time zone. It is measured in that way. So you download it, and you can see here it's only 50 MB or 65 MB the zip file. It's easy. You just download it and then put it into the server, double click it, it will unzip, and then through the setup process you just install it. It doesn't take more time, the installation. I think maximum 15 to 20, 30 minutes at the most, like that way. You reminded me one more good thing about it. The Moodle allows you to create your courses, have the language packs in around, I think, 5 or 6 Indian languages. There is a university in UP, I assisted them, and they have installed the Hindi language pack. So they can have their courses in Hindi as well. By default, it is English, but you can create, and you can see the language pack here on the screen, where you can see my mouse pointer. And there are various language packs available. You can see from here the list. And say you have Bangla, so those who in Assam and West Bengal, they know it. Then the next one is coming up English, you already know. And then you have Gujarati, you have Hindi, there you can see it. And then I remember that I think there was Tamil somewhere, and Malayali also there were. Okay, Marathi is there, Punjabi is there, Tamil is there. I don't know whether Telugu is there or not, because below Tamil there are some our Indian. I think there is Telugu, this TE maybe for Telugu. And you can see that how the people are using the downloads. It is showing you how much into the what extent it is being used. So it's a wonderful thing. You can install it on your systems from there. So once you create it, then it becomes very easy to create your course. So let me take you, first let me show you our my university platform. This is our learning management system, and we have many courses already installed on it. The thing which you are seeing here will be used by you. This is the name of the course, this is some description, and here it's some image related to, because you will be doing the same thing for you. So just see how the people, they have you know, used the graphics to explain their courses. This is history course, mathematics, microeconomics, educational research, like that. So there. And we have this is our recent release for there, and there are various courses which have been created. So it depends on the display, the theme which you select, and accordingly the courses will be you know, visible to the visitors when they go to the website, that system. So that way it goes. Let me just shift the page so that, okay, here, and let me close it, and let me go to my website. Now creating a course is very easy. Once, suppose you have created your account, and after that you need to log into your course. You can make all these settings once you are inside your course. So just remember one thing, that when you create your course, am I not audible? Is my microphone mute? No, my microphone is working. Am I not audible to anyone? Okay, okay, thank you, because I saw a message. Okay, Savita ji is asking what to fill. site will be hosted from. If it is asking you to select the server, you can select anyone. I think there is one Ireland or Australia or something. It doesn't matter. And the next question is what to fill. I don't get it that where what was to be filled up. If you can let me know, then I can tell you. Otherwise, there. Okay, so just please try doing it after completion of lecture and ask. Okay, remember that you are the administrator of your website because you have created it now, and you are the chief boss here. So remember that your role as a site administrator is as like you are the vice chancellor of a university. You can do everything within the system from there. So your role is supreme. When you create, you log default, like just let me show you. Let me log out. And this will be useful for you also. See, the username by default here is admin, so that you remember it. And the password which you select. So when you create your, and after that, when you try to log in next time, and if you put something, your username, say like if I put RC Sharma, my username here, I may not be able to log in. So that is the main thing. You need to remember it because you are the administrator. You are logging through your admin account. So after you log in to your account in the administrative capacity, after that, like a vice chancellor, once posted into the university, then they can appoint other people. So after that, you can, add other roles into it. What other roles are possible here? There are in Moodle, there are four basic roles. The administrator, equivalent to, like I said, vice chancellor. The second role is manager, as you can see from here. That is the next powerful role. You can consider it equivalent to the registrar of the university. Can do many things. Registrar is still very powerful position, but not as powerful as vice chancellor. Then the third role is teacher. The teacher means teacher can be a course creator, a teacher, or a non-editing teacher. The basic difference is that depending on, a teacher may not create a course. That comes in your institutional server position if it is created there. So a course creator can create a course and design a course. A teacher can only design the course. They may not create a course, means launch a new course like that. And a non-editing teacher just can manage assignments or something like that. So the power is decreasing in this order as you go down. And students, they can just interact with the content there. So when you enroll users to your Moodle, then you need to see that you are enrolling anyone in what capacity in your course. So that was a bit of the background for that. This is site administration of where you can take control of everything on your website. Everything, whatever, however it will look like, however, whatever it will behave, it will be, it, you can control it from here. Site administrations means these are the things on which, how it will look like the front page settings, mobile app settings, its security, IP blocker, how the message system will work, how the notification system will work, what language packs are available and which language pack you can install into it. Badges, these are the open badges nowadays, very popular in industry. They give you a badge, like the badge you give to the class monitor, and that is the designation. So here the badge refers to the expertise. You enroll students in your course and then you give them, okay, the expert, the beginner, the intermediate, like that. You can create badges and they are quite helpful over there. From the users tab, you can manage your users. You can add a user, you can add a cohort, you can upload users. in one go. You have 100 students in one through one command. All can be added into it, and like that. Then from here you can manage all your courses. You can create a new category. You can add a new course. You can restore a course. You can take a backup, like that. So these are things. Then it has a grade book. So you can take the examination. And nowadays we all are thinking about having online examination. So here it helps you in having your examination rendered, and then it will create the grades, the marked list, which you normally say, and then that can be given to the examination branch. And how the appearance will appear, where you can put your logo, where you can calendar, like on my website on the left, you may see that my tweets, they are visible when you come to homepage, and those kind of things. How means the appearance, from where you can control these things, you go there. So this is a brief tour of the Moodle system, that what are the capabilities, what are the functionalities into it. Dr. Samita is asking, how are users added by sharing link? Actually, the users are added through various methods, and there are certain enrollment procedures to do that, and they allow you that how you will be allowing the students to come into your course. So the enrollment, it depends on whether you are making it a self-enrollment or through the institutional enrollment. You can add them into one. So both everything is possible here in it. You can make your course open to the people or password. It is always better to keep it a password protected. Here we call it as a key, K-E-Y key, chabi wala key, that. So anyone puts that key into it, it can be any alphanumerical word, and then they can enroll into the course through self-enrollment. We will see that how the enrollment is done from there. So we will be studying two things, how to handle users and how to create a course. So first, we will create a course. Okay, Punita ji is asking, after creating a site in Genome, how are courses added? Okay, now those of you who have their course either on this Genomeo or on Moodle, the process will remain same. Okay, Punita, you have got your site ready? Type in chat box. If it is ready, just type yes. Okay, can you share your screen? Do you know how to share your screen? I can guide you so that everyone sees that how to do it. Because course creation is our first priority. After once course is created, then I will demonstrate how to add students into it. On your screen, you will find an icon, a U-shape icon with upper arrow into it. That is to share your screen. You click on that, and then it will open a window in which it will show you various frames of your computer. From there, you select the web browser one, because it is online, and from there you may see the web browser. That particular window you have to select. Are you able to do that? Okay, it looks like Dr.
Just a second.
Yeah, yes, very good.
Am I sharing your screen?
Yes, we can see it
now. Is it visible?
Yes, it is visible. Good. Can others just acknowledge by typing yes in the chat box? All can create their account on Genome and try additional mark, ask their queries tomorrow. Yes, it is a good idea that please create your account Maybe now you can just watch it if you have not able to create so far. And after the session, you create it and then try. And then tomorrow when we have our session. Okay, which role? By default, you are administrative role. So keep that. Like here, you see the administrator. You can see. Okay, now you are in the administrative user. Just you see those three parallel lines in the upper left corner. Click on that. Yes. Okay. This is your administrative menu. Whatever. Okay. In the Moodle, please pay attention. You can divide your screen into three portions: left, middle, and right. Okay. Whatever mostly on the left will be for site-wide implementation. Here, yeah, Moodle Cloud is also the same. Now, what you are seeing, the the screen which you are seeing of Dr. Punita here, it is same for everyone. Only the just the there may be some, like in Moodle Cloud, you won't see this kind of advertisement, sync analytics. It won't be there in Moodle Cloud. In Moodle Cloud, it will be completely plain because they don't need. Here, so the site-wide administration things come on the left. In the center, your content, what you will be creating, and on the right, about it will appear related to the. It will go there. So first, what you will do. How to create a course. Now, Punita ji, please click on site administration, because at present there is no course. At present there is no course, but when you start building your course, you will be able to see them on the home page. At present there is nothing. Okay, scroll a bit little, just a little bit, so that this advertisement goes up and, okay, yes, yes, yes. No, little bit more. Yeah, please stop. Here, see, as I was showing you, this is your all administrative area. You can do now everything related to this one. Site administration is to manage your site. Then click on users. Deepak ji, is your microphone on? Okay, click on this. This is about the users. Here you can manage your users. We will be adding users later on, and you can browse them, you can see them, what they are doing. And if you read the cohorts there, the difference between a user and cohort is that every year, every semester, you teach new students, and every semester you get say 50, 60 students, and it is not a good idea that you keep on adding them one by one, one by one. So we create a cohort of them in Excel sheet and just upload them in one go. So one command, all the students are added in one go from there. Now please click on courses. Next, okay, maybe Punita ji, if you are not speaking, you can mute your phone, microphone also. Let's see if we can cut the noise coming from which I can unmute everyone, but I may have to, you know, change my window and that. Okay, now let's see here. At present it says it is not showing you the course name. Here it is, the first option is manage courses and categories, second add a category, third restore a course. But later on when you create a course, it will show you backup your course, because by that time you will be having a course, and then you will take a backup and restore it like that. So those of you who have currently are using my Moodle Cloud, create your course, no harm. That is the company original thing, and there are many features available on that which you will be making use. And then later on, if it asks you for subscription or for anything, then take a backup and restore it here. So that way it is perfectly all right. Now please click on manage courses and categories, the first one. Yes, please see here. Now, what is a category and what is a course? A course is your course. Say, for example, microbiology. It is a course. But microbiology comes under what? Broad classification may be biology or biosciences. So you can think of category as an Almira, in which means model as a such is an Almira, and in an Almira you have various shelves. So one shelf, one category, and in that shelf you have various files arranged there, which you can treat it as your course. So category is the broad classification in which you will be placing your courses. Example of category, for example, you can create a category PG, UG, professional, something like that, depending on what you want to do, and create a course, creating a course like that. So, and then when we create a course, it will ask us to put it somewhere. So you can just quickly create new category. Otherwise, by default, there is a miscellaneous category already available. That's why it is showing you. But let's create a category. Okay, name of the, and click on this box first. Under click on miscellaneous, yes, and select, click here, and select top. Now, what the top here means that it will be. It will become a separate category now. Otherwise, it will go under the miscellaneous. Now, give the category name. Say, for example, you can give, if you are creating UG courses, type here undergraduate. If you are creating a PG level course, maybe a postgraduate and something. Depends. Whatever you want, think okay for you, you can write it. There is no need for ID number. If you want, sometimes you can say UG1 or something. And in description, if you want, you can type something that all the UG courses are placed here pertaining to whatever, science, something, but not, this is not the necessary field. And click on create category. And under a category, you can create a subcategory also, that depends. So just scroll down and see here. Now you see there are two categories appearing. One is miscellaneous and another is undergraduate level courses. Okay. And see on the right now, the main heading on the top is undergraduate level courses on the to the right of this window, to the right, the next window. Yeah, yes, undergraduate. Now this category has been created. So this is our, in a way, like a library shelf. And on that library shelf, we need to place our books. So one book will be equal to one course, and like that. Now click on create a new course, and it is not necessary that a course has to be created under a particular category. If you somehow while creating it created your course in a different category, you can always anytime move it from one category to another category. So no issue in that. That way Moodle is very powerful. Please think of a course. All of you just decide that what you want to create and give the full name. Full name like introduction to microbiology. That is the full name.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Can I write some other name which is not biology?
No, anything. I'm just giving the example. You can write any name. Any name. And you can treat it as a sample course. So, and this can be changed anytime. I will show you. If you have kept the name Vivekananda Teachings here, later on you want to put Tagore's teaching for modern age, anytime you can. Now, this is important, short name. Short name, just can you, do you see modern age group, your name? So that dashboard site administration courses, this is the path, this is the navigation. So the short name will come. That's why keep name short, it will be added. If you lengthen, name will become longer. So here you can say simply keep Vivekananda, that's only an identification for you. that you can easily identify the course. A short name for it.
Type somebody here. Is doing some decline.
Please type a short name, for example, Vivekananda here, or teaching modern age, whatever you think that immediately by having a look at that. Yes, good. Now the third is category. It is already under level course, but by clicking it here, if there are many categories, you can select that this course will go under which category. Okay. The next is course visibility. Show and hide. If you keep it show, and it will be visible to everyone who are enrolled in this course. And if you hide it, it won't be visible to any other person except you. You can still see everything because you are the vice chancellor of your course. But hide and seek, that is there. The next here is the start date and end date of the course. So you need to decide, and you can see here, it allows you up to the date and time. So you can close at a particular time also, like at 5 o'clock, the course is going to be closed. No more registration into it. Something like that. Okay. Yeah, click. Yes. That is for hour and minute. So it is 9:30. Yes. So this means polls will start tomorrow at 9:30, and 9:30 it is AM because it follows the railway timetable, the 24 hours of format. And similarly, you are going to close this course on 30th of May and whatever the time you select. Okay, please scroll down. Now comes the description. It is not compulsory, but it is important. Why description? You can consider it as a short abstract, a summary of your course, but please don't make it a big paragraph. I prefer not more than 3-4 sentences in briefly to tell your students or your visitors, if you are offering commercial courses, that what they will be expecting from this course. Because a heavy paragraph will attract a lot of scrolling into it, and that is not a good practice. Yes, so that way you can write anything, and you can make it just select a text, say like Sri Vivekananda, select that text, and now you can bold it, click on B, bold, yes, and the first button is called as expander into this, yes, click on it, and it will show you the rest of the functions. Yeah, you can see here, so you can underline, you can strike, superscript, subscript, adjustment, left aligned, right aligned, like that. And then those of you who belong to mathematics field, you have the can you just take your pointer little bit up, and I will tell you. Okay, below line, below, and to the right, one more, 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 next, next, yeah, here, this, click on it. So those of you who are from mathematics or even science, you need to sometimes type mathematical or scientific symbols. So this is equation editor. If you type something here and select from there, then it will represent it, and you can see the equation preview below this box. You can see that how it will look there. So that way in science fields, when you need these things, it supports them. You can type it, and in the bottom save equation, and it will be saved. Yeah, it has all the mathematical functions, equations. Is this as user friendly Microsoft Teams? No, Microsoft Teams is a different thing. Microsoft Teams is for managing your content or talking, but that has a different purpose. Particularly, Microsoft Teams is used in association with its 360 degree product, and there's no catch into it. They are offering it, their services, free of cost for a small time. After that, they are going to stop that. Microsoft is a company, not open source company. Okay, click on save equation. Means like that it will be, when you save it, it will be visible. My purpose was to tell you about its editing features. Okay, scroll down. You can delete it. Yeah, good. It's come. Now stop here. Not a little bit, little bit. Okay. See files. This space allows you to upload some relevant information in terms of an image or a file, document, brochure, banner, anything related to your course. And if you are uploading an image, image has to be GIF, PNG or JPEG. Now please do one thing. Do you know how to drag drop? You please go to your file explorer in your computer and find any image. For example, here any image, and just drag and drop or click within the window. If you are not comfortable with drag and drop function, click inside this box, the downward blue arrow, click there. Punita ji. I didn't see movement of the cursor, so I thought that whether you are disconnected or not.
Trying to get.
Just a demonstration, any image will do. Not necessarily of Swami Vivekananda right now, but any image can do. Which, of course, you can change any time later on as well.
What happened to my screen now? Can you see my screen?
Yeah, we see your screen, but I don't see any movement of your cursor on it. Can you scroll? Let us see.
Yeah, okay. So, okay, it's clear that we can better, not everybody will be able to do, I think. So we have a file here, a GIF of JPG or PNG here.
Yeah, select anything. In the meantime, let me answer this question. Perhaps this question is by Swita ji. Is there any easy way to write full equation in mathematics? Yes, yes, yes. I showed it to you. And in fact, if you are able to get it installed on your university servers, there is a plugin called as Viris, WIRIS. That is a mathematics plugin. It will can give you more power for mathematics. There is one more question. Oh, that I have already replied Swatiji's question. And in mathematics for accounts as well. Yes, you just saw it. From there, you can select those mathematical functions. Okay, can you click on course format now? Any other colleague? Otherwise, I can go ahead with my account to demonstrate, or we can wait for Punita ji to come back again.
Yeah, so, course format.
Okay, please bring your screen.
I think it was this one.
No, your screen is not being shared. Anyone else, Dr. Gajanan? Can you? Are you in a position to, if your account is ready, can you share? Yes. Otherwise, I will switch to my screen and then give a demonstration to you. I thought that if you use your screen, it will be more easier for every one of you. Anita ji, okay, Vatsala ji is asking, we can click on blue arrow and then a profile is here. Yes, that is the way. There are two ways, either just drag and drop. So do one thing, go to your file folder, click on that image, don't leave the mouse button, click on that, keep it hold and bring it area and then release it. That way, otherwise the easy thing is that click on that blue arrow, downward arrow, then it will ask you to upload it and that way. How to take a backup in Moodle and shift the course? Yeah, we will see it when we are able to create a course first. No, you don't need to reorganize it. The entire course will be just, it will go there. Yes, let's first create a course and then we can go into it. So let me switch to my screen to save the time because it's already 3:30. And I don't want you to be engaged for a long time. So here is the course. Let me show you, add a new course. I hope you are able to see my screen. Can you just confirm? Okay, thank you. So here, let me create a course on all about coronavirus. This is the full name and corona is the short name, and I can select, there are so many categories, and maybe I can select a category of say AUD. It is visible, this is the time, and about coronavirus I can say that this course will explain the emergence of viruses and their effect on our health. Anything, whatever you want to like. Then here comes my thing. So what I will do, I'll simply go to my pictures folder and I will select some relevant image if I have, and I will add into it. Okay, I don't have a photograph of but I'm just getting print. This is called as drag and drop. I'll drop it here, and now this image has come. After that, course form. This is important for you. There are four kind of formats available. The last two are topics format and weekly format. They both are in a way same. They work on the same format. Topics means, now I have selected this virus. So what topics I can think on it? Definition of viruses, type of viruses, treatment of viruses, like that. So these are the topics. If I go with weekly format, so in week one, I will teach definition. In week two, I will teach types of, I will, week three, I will find detection of viruses, something like that. Now the top, otherwise the two other are single activity format. This is good for when you think of having a course, like you created 10 videos for your course, only the videos, no other exercise. And you want your students to see all the videos in the sequential manner, and then you think that the course is complete. So that may go as the single activity format. Or you can, you just have only the quizzes into it that way, only one type of activity. Social format is something like discussion forum. You create that and then you pose a question, you raise a question that what should be done by us so that we are able to beat this pandemic of coronavirus. This is an open question and it is a social format. So what will happen here? All the students of my class, they will contribute their discussion into it. That can go as the threaded discussion. So my question, all the students answer. Then like Dr. Gajanan can reply to the comment of Dr. Punita and like that. So the discussion goes on that. Then these are the number of sections. You can increase them, no problem. Then you want them to remain hidden, collapsed, or expanded format. It's better to remain, let them remain hidden. And show all the sections on one page for one section on one page, it depends on you. I prefer all the sections on one page so that immediately we can see how many sections are there. Then appearance, how it will look like. Course language, announcement kitna dikhna hai, if the students are able to see the grade book or not, their activity or not. So these we don't touch them by default. But this is important, files and upload. Please remember that if you have created your account in Genomeo, there you have got 10 GB. And if it is in Moodle Cloud, it will give you around 200 MB or 400 MB of the space. So please make it little less for the students, say around 2 MB. It means for one file, not overall. You give the assignments to your students and they have to upload their assignment. If it is a heavy file, your space, you can see here is the upper. If I click on it, it will show me these many users and these many MBs they have already been used. This page will be filled up very quickly if that goes to that side. So that way. And anyway, I will tell you further that we don't need to upload our material on Moodle. We keep it separately in our Google Drive or somewhere else, and from there we give the linking. Tracking is for, if you click on yes, then it will track that whether the activities which you asked your students to do, they did it or not. So this is very important to keep a track of the learning. And if you click on yes, then you can see, you can make the learning analytics from there. Groups, if you have large number of groups, you can divide them, large number of students, you can group them accordingly, 10 in one group, 10 in another group, and like that. Role name is for the students. If you don't want them to call as the student, say in some universities, we prefer them to, call, to be called as learner. So software says that the word is student, but if you want to say them like share, or chela or whatever, you can type that word here and the software next time use that word, not this word, but for this course only, not for overall course, because we are doing it for this course. And once all is done, you click on save and display. So here, once we are now save and display, it is offering us two positions. One to the right, enroll users. I can at this stage, at present, number of participants is zero. Nobody is there, but I can enroll more students, or I can simply proceed to course content. Means I can start building, because I can anytime later on, I can add the students in my course. And just quickly, I can show it from here that if I want to enroll the users, I click on enroll users and it will show me this enroll selected users or cohorts. So this is the cohort, select cohort. Cohort means a group of students, 50, 60, 100,000, 10,000, whatever it is. In one go, all will be added. Or you can select a particular student. You can just start typing some initials and then it will automatically find them and add them there, and then what role you want to give them. By default it is student, but you can make them these people. Now remember here, you are administrator, so you are the top. These all are below your level. So manager, teacher, non-editing or student, these are the roles it allows you. By default you keep, but you can add any other person as your teacher also in that course. So two people can teach. So they will have access to all the content for this course only, not for other courses. If I have 50 courses and if I'm adding Dr. Parveen there, so he's the teacher only in this one courses. He can't see my other courses. So that way it is safe. So let's see as a student and just click on enroll and the students are enrolled into it. From here also you can make it open through the enrollment, make it an open enrollment. We call it as self-enrollment. The students can visit your website, they find the course, if they find it useful, they can self-enrollment. It is very good for the situation in which you are offering some free MOOC. That okay, I have these many courses, if anybody wants to study them, come and study like that, at that time. Not a good idea for using that for your regular course. That. Okay, and then you go and proceed to course content. So this is now your inside the course, but let us see how it is appearing outside the course, means what we created there, how it should look like. So here is these are all the course categories which I created. And I remember that I added that course to my AUD directory. So let us see. And see, here is the course. This was the name of the course which we gave. Here was the image. And here is this explanation which will appear. Similarly, for other, these are, you see the way which you can adjust the appearance of your course. So image this side, text this side, in this side, image and text both this side, that one, then no image, then no nothing, text, simple course name, and you click on anything, it takes you to that course inside the course. Is it okay up till here? Let me see if there is a enter name and email. Sorry, that was some person. Okay, if you want to ask any, can we save anyone's video for future reference? Monica is asking, can we save anyone's video for future reference? My answer is no, because it may be copyright protected video. So, but anyway, we will come to that kind of question when we are adding our course material into the course. So I hope that so far it is clear. Or if you can type it into the chat box, and you can, yeah, we will just discontinue. Let me just briefly, very quickly tell you so that you can do the practice when you create your course, then how to proceed from this stage. Because now you will be building your real course from this side. On your course, see, this is the collapsible button, this, those three lines on the top. This is called as hamburger icon. The name is called as hamburger icon. So, you know, it is a toggle switch. You click on it, your administration window will come. You don't click, you hit, and the course is expanded and you add all these things. This gear icon is very important for you. On the upper right corner on the screen, this gear icon. And you always remember that the first one, edit settings, means to change the name of the course or its appearance. That the image which I added there, I want that image to be replaced. I can do it from here. And the second one is turn editing on. You need to be using this turn editing on. And now my course is ready, so I can take a backup. Here is the backup, and I can restore a course already created in my some other time here by restoring it. You click on turn editing on. Now you will see all these things coming up on your screen. This pencil sign shows that you can edit that pencil sign. So here I will just rename it, and I will say definition of virus and press enter. So it is renamed. Second topic, I can type types. Third, I can say treatment. And like that. Now, this four edged icon, this is to readjust. Suppose you thought that, oh no, treatment should come first and then something else. So you can very well hold it there and just drag and drop at a relevant place and release it. So that way you can anytime readjust those. Okay. And then here is the thing, add an activity or resource. By clicking on it, you will see now all these things which can be added in our course. You can add a page, you can add a URL, you can add a folder on which you can put all your files. You can add a one file, you can add a book. Book means having a online book in which you have various chapters. So student will read first chapter, second chapter, and then like that. And here, assignment, give your students to do it. And then discussion forum you create, you ask them to create a glossary, a lesson, it's a branching lesson. So like in virus, what is there, Vivekananda teaching, where he was born, so his personal life, his social life, like that. Speeches, you know, make branching out of that. So I think I can stop here, because I want you to do certain practice of this which we have dealt so far. And if there are any questions, you can ask them now, or otherwise please try it and keep your questions ready. We will connect tomorrow, and then we will see rest of these activities, and we will see your page which you have created. Let me see. Okay, I wrote an Punita Jit saying I wrote an email address for a student to be enrolled, but it did not accept it. No, actually there should not be any problem into it. But can you share your screen now so that we can see what was the mistake? No, email ID is okay. Okay, this is Dr. Gajendra's email ID. Okay, let me demonstrate it. Let me copy it. Just wait there. Let me show you how to add a student. I'm copying this email. Let me go back to my course. Here is share. This is that course, coronavirus. Okay. Now, first remember that before you add a student to your course, it need to be present in the database. At present, Gajendar is not in the database. Let us see. I go to site administration. Side by side, you also do the same thing on your computer. And you, when you come to the site administration, you go to users. From here, you can browse a list of users to see who are the users in your system, in your database. They are in your database, not in the course. The whole. Think that all the people who are inside the university at present, but those who are in science lab, those who are in biology lab, and like that. So I will add a user first, and this is very fast and simple process. Gajendra ji, you please note it down. Your username is GA. And sorry if you know wrongly representing your name. So username, for the time being I'm keep making it short. We need only five things about a particular student to be added into the database. And here is the password. I cannot see the password once I make it, but I can always reset it. So as an administrator, some of your students may contact you that sir, वो मेरा password नहीं चल रहा, मैं password भूल गई, ये है वो है. You can always come back to this place. You won't be able to change their password that way. They can use forget password and reset new password through login, not here. And once the password is there also, it will be a user. So you can reset it. So the password, I'm typing it here, which will be visible to everyone. I'm just making it Sonipat at 2020. You can see it, Sonipat at 2020. Okay, this is the, and what I will do now, because others have seen this password, I will click on force change password. So what it will do, as soon as you log into my course, it will ask you to change your password, and this password will then be deleted from the system. So okay, I need your full name. JANAN Gaja. Is it okay? Okay, I'm keeping it lit now. Surname, I'm just typing Deo, and here is your email ID. So these are the five things you need: first name, last name, email ID, username, and password. These are the five things you need for a particular student, and rest of the things are there. I need to convert it because I was in Malaysia, so it is still running from there. But in your case, you need to select this time zone and select the Indian time zone. In my case, it is Malaysia, and I will go to Asia, and I will find where is Kolkata. Now it will become the Indian time zone. And if I Gajananji can send me his picture, I can add it here, or he can himself do the same. And then I simply create the user. So now this user has been added to my database. What I will do now, I will go to the course so that I can add this user. This is that course. Now, please, everybody pay attention. How to add students to your course now. In your course, you need to be in your course. After that, click on this course management icon, gear icon, and go to more, which is the last option in the more. And here, users. You have to see enrolled users. And somebody asking me the enrollment methods. Now see here, manual enrollments. And you need to self-enrollment, you need to activate from the site administration. So you will be clicking on enrolled users. And at present, there is only one participant. You remember, I added him at that time. I need to add more. So I will click on this on the right, enroll users. And the role will be as a student. And I will first G. And if there is any person with G, it will show me. So here is this. I'll just simply select. It has come here, and I click on enroll selected users. So just see, there are two people now. So Gajanandev email ID, student role, not in any group, and here the participant is in this course. So now what you need to do now, how to share this course with you now. You need this ID, which I will just type in the chat for everyone. So this is the URL. The password you already noted, and you need to use your username at GAJA, and you can log in right now. Also, you can try it. You can just simply click on this. It will ask you username and password. And it's better that if you can share your screen, we can all see that how you are logging in to your, we can generate password. System can also generate password. Jyoti is asking. So both things are okay. Let me stop sharing my screen. Otherwise, Gajananji will not be able to share his screen. So are you able to do? Or you can do one more thing. You can click on this also, and then use your username and password, and you will be able to come inside the course. Anyone else? Punita ji, can you, if Gajanan has not changed the password, the password is known, anyone can share their screen and can try it. In the meantime, any questions from other colleagues? Okay, Dr. Shashma is sharing the screen. Let us see. Yes. Okay. And password was S capital, rest are in lower case. Click on login. It was Sonipat at 2020, but provided if Gajananji has not changed it, because on first login it will ask you to change the password. Yeah, you can close this dark strip on the bottom. It is just simply continue. You can click continue. No issue. Yes. Now you are inside the course. Yes. Please select these policies. This is there. Scroll down, and at the end of the page, it will show you. Okay, go to next page. Okay, close this from the top. There is small on the top of this page. Click that cross sign. Just little bit more. Yeah, here. Yes. Okay. Yeah. I thought that you are inside the course. If it is not there, I will reset it again. And I'll type it in the chat box. Yes. Okay. So now see, I told you that if you log in for the first time, it will ask you to change your password. So please put the current password and then select your new password, whatever you want it. Looks like your kids, they are helping you. They are technically advanced children. Okay, save changes. Yeah, there is some mistype. Yeah, password has been changed. Okay, continue. Click on continue. Okay, you need to say yes to these policies. Go to the bottom of the page. And click on next. Yes. Actually, please note that this will for all of you, because the Moodle asks you to agree to their terms. Next. And on third page, you need to tick at two places. Yeah, there are these two. Please tick them. And then accept at the bottom. Yes. These are simple policies. It says that we don't misuse your. Okay, you are here now. This is your opening page. It will show you some tool. You can end it. There is no. It will tell you what are the features. So this is your course, which you can. If you don't see it by any chance, you can always go to site home, and from there you can come back. So this is inside this course how it will look to the student. Okay, and since I have added you as a student, you won't be able to, but I will change your role to the teacher so that you can update this course from your side. In that case, I'll just after this meeting, I will do it, and then in the evening, do some practice. And then tomorrow, maybe we can use this course also as a demonstration course forever. Okay, friends. Sakina ji, anything anyone wants to say? Any questions? This model is used by.
I just want to say thank you for such an informative lecture and very comprehensive demonstration of the Moodle course. I hope it will be useful for all the participants, and they'll come tomorrow with their queries.
Yes.
And success stories. Thank you, sir.
No, you are always welcome. And let me tell you that there is a hospital in Kolkata. A doctor is there. He has created his course on radiology, you know, those X-ray things on Moodle.
Yeah,
and he teaches that course as a free course for doctors. So you see, the application of this platform is across various kind of disciplines. Equation editor, yeah, not enough powerful. Archana ji saying any solution. Yes, let me write it. There is a plugin called as virus plugin. You need to get it installed. You won't be able to install it on Moodle, this one, because company doesn't allow. But if you type, if you have it installed it on your institutional servers, there you can install it. Add many users. In Genomio, you can have up to 250 students, and here up to 50 students. That's why I asked you to, if you have more students than 50, then you can open your account in Genomio. Out of two, which is your final recommendation? Maybe based on that, you can go ahead with Genomio. Because Genomio, when you can keep it a little longer. But me and Sadhana ji, we have been using this Moodle Cloud. I'm using it for the past 5-6 years. It has never, but sometimes, you know, the companies, they change their policy for the new users. I'm having issue with 68 student list on Moodle Cloud. I want to shift to Genomio. But how are you able to have 68 students on Moodle Cloud? It doesn't allow more than 50. Tomorrow we will see how to take a backup, and in real time, we will take a backup of your course from Moodle Cloud and restore it in Genomio. No problem. We will do that tomorrow.
So, sir, we'll see you tomorrow then. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
And I hope everyone enjoyed it. They can use the same link tomorrow also.
Yeah, the URL will remain the same. And thank you, okay, everyone, sir, because it was a new session initially. There was some noise. But I hope that very soon everyone was seated well and the session went well. So my thanks to all of you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks
okay,
once
then.
Again.
Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye. Take care. See you tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Bye, sir.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Have a nice day, sir.
Same to you. Thank you. I'm just waiting for a few more seconds and then I will close so that this meeting is recorded. Okay, now I'm closing. Okay, and have a nice evening, everyone. See you tomorrow.
Okay, sir.